Today, I discuss with you a very important portion of the pineus, that is the development of male gametophyte. In this chapter, we will discuss how the development of male gametophyte, how the development of archegonium take place in pineus. As you know very well, the pineus is a heterosporous plant. In which there are two different shape and size of the spores are produced within the microsporangium and megasporangium. In microsporangium, there is a develop a lot of microspore or pollen grain, as well as in megasporangium, there is a developed megaspore. The megaspore develop within the ovule. As you know, the pineus is a monoecious plant on which male and female cone develop on the same plant but on different branches. Mostly the male cone develop towards the apex of the shoot, and female cone always develop towards the below of male cone in cluster. In male cone and female cone always develop in groups, develop in clusters. So the development of male gametophyte take place from the pollen grain or microspore, and development of archegonium always develop from megaspore. The microspore and megaspore develop into male and female gametophyte. The male gametophyte, as you know very well, in gymnosperm there is no developed antheridium. From pollen grain directly develop male gamete after some division, and from megaspore there is a develop female gametophyte, that is the archegonium. Now I will discuss with you how the development of male gametophyte take place. What happened, as you know very well, if you see the picture of the development of the male gametophyte, I think you can understand very well. This is the picture of the development of the male gametophyte. As you know very well, the pollen grain is the first unit of male gametophyte. And the pollen grain, as you see in last lecture, the pollen grain of the pineus are covered by double layer. It is the pollen grain of the pineus. You can understand the development of male gametophyte through this diagram. These are the diagram which represent the development of the male gametophyte. What happened? As you know very well, the first unit of the male gametophyte is pollen grain. And the pollen grain in pineus is so very special because of they having the lateral balloon like structure in the form of wing, which help in floating the pollen grain in air. They can help in float the by the help of wing, they float in air for long time. The nucleus of pollen grain covered by cytoplasm, and the cytoplasm covered by double layer. The outer is exogen, which is thick and very rough, and inner wall layer is intine. This is the nucleus, and you know very well the pollen grain having a very special structure in the form of wing. First of all, what happened? Remembered it, the nucleus of the pollen grain, first of all, undergoes a transfer wall division. As a result, there is a formation of two unequal cells. The smaller cell is known as first prothallial cell, and larger one is known as apical cell. As a result, the pollen grain become two cells. टू सेल्ड, टू इट इज द टू सेल्ड स्टेज ऑफ द पोलन ग्रेन. नाउ द फर्स्ट प्रोथेलियल सेल डज नॉट डिवाइड फर्दर. नाउ द एपिकल सेल फर्दर डिवाइड बाई सेम डिविजन, ट्रांसफर वाल डिविजन, एंड प्रोड्यूस ए स्मॉलर सेकेंड प्रोथेलियल सेल एंड लार्जर एंथ्रीडियल सेल. एज यू नो वेरी वेल द फर्स्ट एंड सेकेंड प्रोथेलियल सेल डज नॉट डिवाइड फर्दर. द फर्स्ट एंड सेकेंड प्रोथेलियल सेल बोथ सेल्स डज नॉट डिवाइड फर्दर. नाउ द एंथ्रीडियल सेल विच इज द लार्जेस्ट सेल ऑफ द पोलन ग्रेन फर्दर डिवाइड इंटू स्टोक सेल एंड बॉडी सेल्स एज यू सी इन द पिक्चर दैट बॉडी सेल्स एंड स्टोक सेल्स आर अटैच ईच अदर. द स्टोक सेल्स इज ऑल्सो नोन एज बेसल सेल एंड द बॉडी सेल ऑलवेज अटैच विद द स्टोक सेल्स. एट दिस स्टेज द पोलन ग्रेन रिच ऑन द माइक्रोपाइल ऑफ द ओव्यूल एंड दे रिच इन टू द पोलन चैम्बर एंड द फर्दर डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द पोलन ग्रेन टेक प्लेस विद इन द पोलन चैम्बर. At E stage, there is a four cells. देखिए यहाँ पे E stage में आप देखेंगे now the pollen grain become four cells. One is the first and second prothelial cell and stalk cells and body cells. At this stage, the pollen grain, remembered it, the pollen grain release from microsporangium. In case of pinus, always the pollen grain release at four cell stage from the microsporangium. And they reach on the micropyle and enter into the pollen chamber and further development of the pollen grain at the male gametophyte take place within the pollen chamber of the ovule. Side by side, the pollen grain absorb the water and food content from the pollen chamber and they become germinate. As a result, the entine of the pollen grain come out by the rupturing of the axine in the form of pollen tube. As you know very well, the pollen tube of the pollen grain having the hydrolytic enzyme which help in the penetrate the pollen tube into female gametophyte. Now the body cells further divide into generative cells and tube cells. Side by side, the first prothelial cell and the second prothelial cell undergoes degeneration. Now, the generative cells further divide by mitotic division. As a result, there is a formation of two male gametes. Which is known as sperm, and remaining unit of the pollen grain undergoes degradation and they provide their food content to the functional well, that is the male gamete. Now at the time of the fertilization, out of two male gamete, one male gamete filled with the egg cells and produce zygote. So this is the development of the pinus, development of the male gametophyte, which has been reported by gymnologist in the pinus. It is an interesting one in case of pinus, the pollen grain release at four celled stage from the microsporangium and reach within the pollen chamber through the micropyle. You can say that the 70% development of the pollen grain take place within the microsporangium and remaining 30% development take place within the pollen chamber of the ovule. So this is the development of the male gametophyte, and you know very well the wing is remain attached throughout the development of the male gametophyte. So that is the reason behind it. The presence of the wing help in dispersal of spore from one place to another place. So this is the development of male gametophyte. The development of male gametophyte in pinus take place in two stages. the development of male gametophyte before pollination and the development of male gametophyte after pollination. As you know very well, when the four-celled, the pollen grain become four-celled within the microsporangium after dehiscence of the megasporangium wall, the pollen grain by the help of air they reach on the micropyle of the ovule. So after the pollination the pollen grain reach into the pollen chamber and further development take place within the pollen chamber of the ovule. So development of the pinus take place in two phases: the development which take place before the pollination and the development which take place after the pollination. As you know very well that in pinus are all member of the gymnosperm, the pollination always take place by the wind, anemophily hota hai, wind hota hai. Now I will discuss with you the development of female gametophyte in pinus through the diagram. In pinus, the development of female gametophyte take place within the ovule. As you know very well, when the ovule are young, they appear green in color, and very soon after some time the ovule become mature and they become red or brown in color. At this stage the nucellus, as you know very well, in young ovule the ovule made of two part. The center part is known as nucellus, which is a multicellular structure made of meristematic tissue and covered by this central part of the ovule, that is known as nucellus, covered by a single integument in young stage. When the ovule become mature, any cells of the nucellus which situated towards the micropyle direct function as megaspore mother cell, which is diploid in nature. What happened? Now the megaspore mother cell, I have discussed lab also, now the megaspore mother cell 2N undergoes reduction division and produce four daughter megaspore cells. That is the 1, 2, 3, and 4. And out of 4 megaspore which become haploid in nature, out of 4, 3 which situated toward the micropyle become degenerating, and lowermost become functional, and we have and from this functional megaspore the whole development of Archegonium take place. What happened? First of all, this lower functional megaspore become large in size, which having single nucleus, and this first of all this nucleus after increasing their size, this nuclear undergoes nuclear division. As a result they produce near about 2,000 to 2,500 nuclei which distributed throughout the cytoplasm of the functional megaspore. Now like in cycas, देखिए डेवलपमेंट सेम लगभग साइकस की तरह होता है. नाउ लाइक इन साइकस ए सेंट्रल वैक्यूल डेवलप इन द सेंटर ऑफ द फंक्शनल मेगास्पोर. एज ए रिजल्ट द ऑल न्यूक्लाई अरेंज टुवर्ड्स द पेरीफेरी, नाउ ए वेरी लिटिल डिफरेंस बिटवीन द साइकस एंड पाइनस डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द फीमेल गैमेटोफाइट विच रिपोर्टेड बाई जिम्नोलॉजिस्ट एज during the wall formation. Now the wall formation take place from periphery to center, and during the wall formation what happen in case of pinus, remembered it, ये मैनी मल्टीन्यूक्लेट इलोंगेटेड सेल्स आर डेवलप इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एलोवलाई. सो प्रेजेंस ऑफ एलोवलाई एंड डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द एलोवलाई ड्यूरिंग द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ फीमेल गैमेटोफाइट इज द कैरेक्टर फीचर्स ऑफ द ऑर्डर कोनिफरेस, कैरेक्टर फीचर्स ऑफ द पाइनस. इन साइकस यू कैन सी ड्यूरिंग द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ फीमेल गैमेटोफाइट देर इज नो फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एलोवलाई लाइक स्ट्रक्चर, बट इन केस ऑफ पाइनस ड्यूरिंग द वॉल फॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम पेरीफेरी टू सेंटर द वॉल फॉर्मेशन टेक प्लेस इन सच ए मैनर दैट ए मैनी मल्टीन्यूक्लेट इलोंगेटेड बैंड लाइक स्ट्रक्चर इज फॉर्म इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एलोवलाई. सो द प्रेजेंस ऑफ एलोवलाई इज द डायग्नोस्टिक फीचर्स ऑफ द पाइनस. नाउ दिस ऑल द एलोवलाई फर्दर टेक प्लेस डिविजन एंड ऑल एलोवलाई फ्यूज ईच अदर एंड प्रोड्यूस मल्टी सेलुलर मेरिस्टमेटिक सेल्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ न्यूक्लियस और इन द फॉर्म ऑफ फीमेल गैमेटोफाइट. दिस पोर्शन ऑफ द फंक्शनल मेगास्पोर व्हेन द मेगास्पोर बिकम मल्टी सेलुलर एट दिस स्टेज द मेगास्पोर नोन एज न्यूक्लियस नोन एज फीमेल गैमेटोफाइट और एंडोस्पर्म नोन एज एंडोस्पर्म. सो इन केस ऑफ पाइनस द एंडोस्पर्म रिमेन हैप्लोइड इन नेचर बिकॉज दिस एंडोस्पर्म डेवलप फ्रॉम द हैप्लोइड फंक्शनल मेगास्पोर. नाउ द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ आर्चिगोनियम टेक प्लेस फ्रॉम दिस एंडोस्पर्म. हाउ द आर्चिगोनियम डेवलप फ्रॉम द न्यूक्लियस? एनी वन सेल्स विच सिचुएटेड टुवर्ड्स द माइक्रोपाइल एनी वन सेल्स बिकम सुपरफिशियल एंड डायरेक्टली फंक्शन एज आर्चिगोनियल इनिशियल सेल. दिस इज द पोर्शन ऑफ द फीमेल गैमेटोफाइट और एंडोस्पर्म और न्यूक्लियस. एनी वन सेल्स डायरेक्टली फंक्शन एज आर्चिगोनियल इनिशियल सेल विच सिचुएटेड टुवर्ड द माइक्रोपाइल. नाउ दिस आर्चिगोनियल इनिशियल सेल बिकम लार्ज इन साइज एंड साइड बाई साइड दे अंडर गोज द ट्रांसफर वॉल डिविजन एंड दे प्रोड्यूस ए स्मॉलर टुवर्ड्स अपर साइड प्राइमरी नेक सेल्स एंड लोअर साइड लार्ज सेंट्रल सेल. नाउ द प्राइमरी सेल्स आफ्टर द वर्टिकल एंड पेरिकिलियल डिविजन प्रोड्यूस नेक सेल्स विच अरेंज इन टू टायर्स. देर आर एट नेक सेल्स आर फॉर्म्ड ड्यूरिंग द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ आर्चिगोनियम. सो द माउथ ऑफ द आर्चिगोनियम कवर्ड ब्लॉक बाय द नेक सेल्स बट एट द टाइम ऑफ फर्टिलाइजेशन द सेल्स ऑफ द नेक ऑल नेक सेल्स बिकम डिजोल्व. एज ए रिजल्ट द मेल गैमेटोफाइट एंटर थ्रू दिस माउथ ऑफ द आर्चिगोनियम एंड फ्यूज विद द एग सेल्स एंड साइड बाई साइड द सेंट्रल सेल विच इज फंक्शनल विच इज लार्ज इन साइज फर्दर अंडर गोज माइटोटिक डिविजन एंड प्रोड्यूस ए वेंट्रल कैनाल सेल एंड ए लार्ज एग सेल्स. ड्यूरिंग द फर्टिलाइजेशन व्हाट हैपन द नेक्स्ट सेल्स एंड द वेंट्रल कैनाल सेल बिकम डीजनरेट and produce aromatic substances which attracts the anthrozoites towards the which attract the male gametophyte or sperm towards the egg cells. So this is the mature archegonium of the pinus. You can say that the archegonium covered by jacket cells which protect the delicate part of the archegonium from outer external environmental factor. And it the mature archegonium having ventral canal cell and the mouth of archegonium covered by neck cells which block the unwanted factors entry of the unwanted factors in the archegonium. So this is the development of the female gametophyte. Further I repeat again, this is the functional megaspore. Now the nucleus of the functional megaspore undergoes nuclear division. As a result there is a formation of about 2000 or 2500 nuclei which distributed throughout the cytoplasm. Now a central vacuole is developed in the center of the functional megaspore in such a fashion that the whole nuclei arranged towards the periphery. Now wall formation take place from periphery to center in such a manner that there is a formation of tube like elongated multinucleate structure in the form of alveoli. Now the further wall formation take place in these alveoli in such a manner that the megaspore become multicellular. At this stage, the megaspore known as gandosperm or female gametophyte. Now, the any cells of the nucleus or endosperm of the functional megaspore, which is known as female gametophyte, directly behave as archegonial initial cell. It is a superficial cell and very active as compared than that of the neighboring cells. Now, this cell undergoes transfer wall division and produce towards outer side primary neck cells, which will develop after development neck cells and the central cell. Now, the primary neck cell after vertical and anticlinal division produce the neck cells, which arrange in two tiers, and the total neck cells is 8. And from the central cell, there is a take place mitotic division. As a result, a smaller ventral canal cell and neck cells are produced. And the whole archegonium covered by jacket cells. So this is the development of the archegonium or female gametophyte in pinus. So in a single ovule of the pinus, there is a development of two archegonium. It has been reported by gymnologists that within a single ovule there is a developed two archegonium. And very rarely it has been reported by gymnologists in species to species of pinus. Sometime three archegonia reported in pinus strobus, pinus rigida, pinus racinosa, and 5 to 6 archegonia reported in pinus larixio, and 9 archegonium develop accidentally in case of pinus montana. So this is the development of the female gametophyte, and you can describe the development of female gametophyte on the basis of diagram. As you know very well, the pollination in pinus is take place by the help of wind pollinated hota hai, and the pollen grain of the pinus having the wing, by the help of wing they float in air for long time. What happen during the fertilization take place after a year of pollination. After pollination, the fertilization take place after 1 year. The pollen tube containing 4 nuclei, tube nuclei, stalk, and 2 male gamete. And during the fertilization, these tube nucleus and the stalk nucleus become degenerate, and out of 2 male nuclei, one fuse with the egg cells and produce zygote. ठीक है? Elongated ridge near the tip of archegonium, it penetrate neck cells, and when it come in contact with the egg, it release all its content in vicinity of eggs. Out of 2 male gamete, only fuse with the egg cells and produce zygote. So zygote 2n is formed after the fertilization. It is a result of the male gamete and egg cells. Now from zygote, the embryo is developed. After fertilization, zygote is formed after fusion of male and female gamete and produce zygote. In pinus, polyembryony take place, which is unique features of pinus. In case of pinus, the polyembryony is the diagnostic features of order. Only accidentally what happened, by the splitting of the zygote, there is a formation of more than two embryo take place. In such a condition, the seed of pinus having more than two embryo. This tendency of plant is known as polyembryony. What happened during the development of embryogenesis? The zygote nucleus, which is 2n, first of all increasing in size. Now the nucleus of the zygote undergoes mitotic division and produce 2 and then 4 nuclei. Now the transfer wall take place. As a result, the zygote become 2-celled, and further vertical wall division take place. The zygote become 4-celled stage. and then transverse wall division take place for the 12 cell stage, and the vertical wall division take place. As a result, the zygote becomes 16 cell stage. At this stage, zygote known as proembryo, Now the tires of the proembryo differentiated into three regions. The uppermost region, cells function as nutritive tire, or hosteria, and the middle layer cells directly function as suspensor cell, and the lowermost cell known as embryonal cell, embryonal tire, and these embryonal tire is responsible for embryo, and the main function of suspensor cell in embryo, as they push the embryo within the nucleus of the seed or endosperm of the seed in such a fashion, in such a manner that the whole embryo absorb their food content from the endosperm. And the main function of nutritive tire is absorb the food content for proper for the development of the embryo. And this is the mature embryo of the pinus. You can see at the apex of the embryo there is a nutritive cells are present. They absorb the water and food content for further development of the male embryo, and there is a suspensor which is further differentiated into primary suspensor cell and secondary suspensor cell, which is elongated and coiled cells, and at the tip of the embryo there is develop more than two embryos. So in case of pinus polyembryony is the diagnostic feature, is the character features of the presence of polyembryo. So what happened during the development of embryo? Accidentally the zygote is splitting into many segments, and these segments of the zygote produce embryo. Accidentally zygote cleavage in many part, and every part of the zygote produce embryo, and this is the embryo of the pinus. You can see there is a plumule above the cotyledons, and this is the cotyledon. There are two cotyledons. The main function of cotyledons in embryo is storage of the food reserve material. Extra जो excess food reserve material होता है वो cotyledons में store रहता है, and during the germination, as you know very well, this embryo develop within the seed. So during the germination what happened? The plumule cells of the embryo develop shoot system, and the radical portion of the cells produce shoot system, and this is the remain of suspensor cell during the germination. All the nutritive tires and the suspensor cell become degenerate. So if you see the structure of seed, this is the seed, this is the seed of the pinus. A very diagnostic features have been reported in seed also. Along with the seed there is a present wing. So dispersal in the seed take place by the help of wing, because the seed of the pinus float in air for long time by the help of wing. So presence of wing in pollen grain as well as in seed is the diagnostic features of pinus. And this is the ovuliferous scale, this is the sterile part of the ovuliferous scales, and the basal portion of the ovuliferous scales having the ovule, and after fertilization what happened? The ovule converted into seed. So after fertilization ovule converted into seed. So this is the how the seed germinate. Under favorable conditions, seed of pinus germinate very soon after dissemination. They don't require any resting period before germination, but they can remain dormant for several years under unfavorable condition. The germination is epigeal type. In case of cycas, the germination of the seed is hypogeal, but in case of pinus, the germination of the seed is epigeal. What happened? The seed remain upper side from the soil top layer. When the germination take place above the soil layer, it is known as epigeal type. The cotyledons come outside the soil surface by the elongation of hypocotyle. The seed coat brushed by absorbing water and radical emerge out through the micropyle appear and enter into the soil. The radical develop into primary taproot or always the root system develop from the radical and the shoot system from the plumule. As a result, after germination of the pinus, there is a developed, diploid, very healthy plant of the pinus. So this is the life history of the pinus, which I discuss with you. Thank you very much.